Good morning.
Good morning.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace and peace from God, our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ, be with you all.
Holy Ghost, hear it.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Jesus, who raised us to new life, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For Jesus, who forgive us our sins, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, who feed us with your body and blood, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us one day to everlasting life.
Amen.
Today's Mass intentions are for unlimited thanksgiving offering and for Nestor Bongabon. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those who set firm on the foundation of your love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our reading from the book of the second book of Kings. Sennacherib, king of Assyria, sent envoys to Hezekiah with this message. Thus saith say to Hezekiah, king of Judah, do not let your God on whom you rely deceive you by saying that Jerusalem will not be handed over to the king of Assyria. You have heard what the kings of Assyria have done to all other countries. They do them. Will you then be saved? Hezekiah took the letter from the hand of the messengers and read it. Then he went up to the temple of the Lord, and spreading it out before them, he prayed in the Lord's presence, O Lord, God of Israel, enthroned upon his cherubim, you alone are God over the kingdoms of the earth. You have made the heavens and the earth. Incline your ear, O Lord, and listen. Open your eyes, O Lord, and see. Hear the words of Sennacherib, which he sent to talk with the living God. Truly, O Lord, the kings of Assyria have laid waste the nations and their lands, and cast their gold, their gods, into the fire. They destroyed them because they were not gods, but the work of human hands, wood and stone. Therefore, O Lord our God, save us from the power of this man, that all the kingdoms of the earth may know that you alone, O Lord, are God. Then Isaiah, son of Amos, sent this message to Hezekiah. Thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, in answer to your prayers for help against Sennacherib, king of Assyria, I have listened. This is the word the Lord has spoken concerning him. She despises you, loves you to scorn, the virgin daughter Zion. Behind you she wipes her head, daughter Jerusalem. For out of the Jerusalem shall come a remnant, and from Mount Zion survivors. The zeal of the Lord of hosts shall do this. Therefore, thus says the Lord concerning the king of Assyria. He shall not reach the city, nor shoot an arrow at it, nor come before him with a shield, nor cast a siege work against him. He shall return by the way he came, without entering the city, says the Lord. I will shield and save the city for my own sake, and for your own sake, and for the sake of my servant David. That night, the angel of the Lord went forth and struck down 185,000 men in the Assyrian camp. So Sennacherib, the king of Assyria, broke camp and went back home to Nineveh. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. God upholds the city forever.
God upholds the city forever.
Great is the Lord and holy to be praised. In the city of our God, his holy mountain, fairest of heights, is the joy of all the earth.
God upholds the city forever.
Mount Zion, the recesses of the north, is the city of the great king. God is with the castles, renewed is he as a stronghold.
God
holds his city forever. O God, we ponder your mercy in your temple. As your name, O God, so also your praise. reaches to the ends of the earth. Of justice, your right hand is full.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not give what is holy to dogs, or throw your pearls before swine, lest they trample them underfoot and tear you to pieces. Do to others whatever you would have them to do to you. This is the law and the prophets. Enter through the narrow gate, for the gate is wide and the road broad and leads to destruction. And those who enter through it are many. How narrow the gate and constrict the road that leads to life. And those who find it are few." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
The Gospel reading this morning, Jesus reduces all of the Jewish law and the prophets to a very short maxim. Always treat others as you would like them to treat you. Jesus invites us to imagine how we would like people to treat us and to ask ourselves the question, what do I really want from another person? So most of us would answer that question along similar lines. We want from others respect, tolerance, loyalty, understanding, compassion, justice. So having engaged in that exercise of thinking about this, or imagining how we would like others to treat us, Jesus then declares that we should act towards others in a way that reflects those very qualities. And then, after that, we hear Jesus saying, "Enter by the narrow gate." So this implies that following Jesus and following the rule of Jesus of treating others as we would want them to treat us will not always be easy. So narrow gates require an effort to get through. And the narrow gate Jesus speaks about then leads us to what he calls the hard road. So in summary, what Jesus is saying is that his teachings requires a daily dying to self and putting the good of others before our own good. So the way that he sets before us is a difficult and challenging way, because sometimes for us it's hard to die to ourselves. And putting the good of others before our own good sometimes is not easy. So it's a challenging way that Jesus is putting before us. But Jesus declares that this is the way that leads us to life. It is a life-giving path for us in the course of our early life. And it will finally lead us to eternal life. So as we continue celebrating the Eucharist, let us ask Jesus for that. so that we can continuously can die to ourselves, to be able to think about putting the good of others before our own good. In this way, Jesus is speaking about this narrow gate that we hear today in the Gospel. Let us offer our prayers and needs to the Father. For all members of the Church, may God continue to renew us in our efforts to spread the good news. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government authorities throughout the world, may the Holy Spirit guide any building societies that reflect the kingdom of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are searching for meaning in their lives, may God open their hearts to His grace, and may they find in Him a firm foundation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in this faith community who are discerning a vocation to the priesthood or consecrated life, may the Holy Spirit grant them various hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an Olympic thanksgiving offering, and for Nestor Pocabon, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal prayers and intentions that we offer in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
All powerful and merciful Father, we ask that you hear our petitions and grant us our needs. We pray this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of your hands, who will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, the work of your hands, it will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of praise and grant that pleased by its action we may make an offering of our heart pleasing to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift your heart to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is to be right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you love your Son. By whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours, that by sinning we have lost in disobedience. So with angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exhortation we have learned.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth,
Lord,
Son and the Christ,
blessed
be the name of the Lord, Son and the Christ.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. May all your qualities be to pray, by sending down your Spirit upon the land of form, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. Let us proclaim Jesus the mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you this morning. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Jesus, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis our Pope, Blaise our Bishop, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of our faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, Saint Padre Pio, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray together as Jesus Christ.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and power and the power of your righteousness.
Lord Jesus, who said to your friends, peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of this community, and graciously grant each one of them peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us offer each other the sign. Then of God to take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
We call Jesus, the takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord. Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the loving God bless us all, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Master sent it all in peace.
Thanks be to God.